Welcome, and thank you for joining our Hyperwall Talk today. My name is Lisa Lamb, and I am the President CEO for the Lewis Center for Educational Research, and today we'll be talking about GAVRT, which is a radio astronomy project that will help you bring the universe to your classroom. What is GAVRT, you might ask? Well, at GAVRT, we are focused on two concepts, real science and real learning, and our mission is to contribute to the scientific body of knowledge, help our students learn how to think like a scientist, and connect our students and citizen scientists to real NASA missions. Here's a brief video that highlights GAVRT in action.
GAVRT is a way that students can learn about science by doing real science. So a key part of what we do with GAVRT is we want students using our big radio telescope to do science that's worthwhile and a good use of the telescope time. Teachers talk about the need for engagement, for getting the students to want to pay attention to what they're doing in class. If I walk into your classroom and say, today we're going to look for life in outer space, I've got 100% engagement. Every kid is interested.
So SETI is Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, and we gather different frequencies, and then we compare that file to another one that was taken on a different date and see if any of the frequencies match up, and that could be a candidate.
We search for black holes, look for black holes, new ones that we haven't found before, so we're just collecting data for that.
We look at stars, constellations, we look at different galaxies and planets and learn new things about them.
We work with a maybe 20,000 ton telescope that is here in California, and we get to move that.
This is DSS 28, our 34 meter antenna that students use from the comfort of their classroom to look into the universe.
For a lot of the students, when they push a button in their classroom and they're watching the video of this huge radio telescope and it starts to move because they made it move, that moment is when they suddenly realize this is different. So I'm the project scientist for Juno, which is a spacecraft that's orbiting Jupiter right now. And one of the science campaigns for GAVRT is students observing Jupiter from the ground with our radio telescope. Science that they do, observing Jupiter on a day-to-day basis or a week-to-week basis over the course of years, is valuable to our mission with the Juno spacecraft at Jupiter. So in some sense, they're part of the Juno science team.
Well, GAVRT really is our flagship project. It's our partnership with NASA JPL, and we've actually just celebrated our 20th anniversary. And it's really just an opportunity for our students to partner with scientists and participate in real ongoing science work by participating in different campaigns or missions or projects with our JPL scientists.
The coolest part about it is just the fact of radio astronomy, and we're looking at objects that are so far away that they happened millions of years ago. It's coming from something that may not even exist anymore. It takes so long for that energy to come to us. So it's almost like looking into the past.
The goal is to get students working hand in hand with JPL scientists, collecting data for existing campaigns, analyzing the data, and then delivering the data, and potentially I would even like them to use the data to support their own hypotheses and their own ideas.
The fact that we said, okay, we're going to trust you with this multi-million dollar piece of equipment. We're going to let you do something real, and we're going to ask you to help contribute to the world, to contribute to the world's body of scientific knowledge. That whole thing, that responsibility, can change the way a kid looks at life and looks at school.
There are many benefits to joining the GAVRT Radio Astronomy team for educators and students. Some of these are that you actually get to work together with students and professional scientists from all around the world to uncover new knowledge about the universe. And that's something that you just cannot get out of a textbook or regular school project. You have the ability to remotely control a 34-meter radio telescope, which belongs to NASA's Deep Space Network, from anywhere in the world. GAVRT has been doing distance learning and virtual learning for all of our 22 years. In fact, when we first began, what you needed to be a GAVRT team member was a fax and a phone line. Of course, we've advanced much more than that nowadays, but the threshold is still really low. Really, all you need is an internet connection and a computer. So almost, this is accessible to almost anybody. You also, as a GAVRT team member, are able to access existing and future curricula that we've developed to support all of our GAVRT campaigns. One really cool thing is that you will receive special invitations to participate in events that are hosted by our GAVRT partners all around the world. Some of these might include special invitations that are mission related, maybe at JPL or with NASA or any of the other partners that we have. And most importantly, you are going to receive support from the Lewis Center and JPL every single step of the way, from the initial training through making sense of the collected data, and our operators would be there to do as much of the heavy lifting in the beginning as you would need. Next, I want to give a really brief overview of each of our current GAVRT campaigns. First is our oldest campaign, Jupiter Quest. And you can see our science and education goals here, but basically through Jupiter Quest, we are teaching students how to collect data on synchrotron radiation and to develop a better understanding of the electromagnetic field. The really great thing is that students are examining and reporting relevant data to the Juno scientists for follow-up. Black Hole Patrol is another one of our longest running campaigns, and our goal with Black Hole Patrol is to monitor radio emission generated by black holes to understand how they affect and are affected by their environment. We have a lot of motivation for that, and kids are very excited to learn more about black holes. Next is our SETI campaign, which is Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence. And like Dr. Levin shared in our video, this one is really easy to get high engagement from students and citizen scientists. Here we're using the GAVRT radio telescope to scan across most of the stars in the Milky Way, and we're looking to see if anyone is sending a radio signal in our direction. With help for citizen scientists and students all over the world, we continue to search through this enormous amount of data, looking for signs that someone is trying to talk to us. Solar Patrol is our newest campaign, and as we have developed this project, we've really placed citizen science and adaptability at the forefront. So as over the last few years, we've been piloting this project with museums, science centers, after-school programs, girls in STEM clubs, etc. And we are excited about how it can mold and fit whatever need there is out there. And especially during times like this, this is really important. So the science behind Solar Patrol is to improve our understanding of how the sun generates space weather and its impact on Earth. And we will be contributing GAVRT data to Owens Valley Solar Array, Parker Solar Probe, and many other relevant projects. So far, I've talked a lot about opportunities for teachers, students, and citizen scientists, but there's a great opportunity for professional scientists with GAVRT. And I think one of the most important things is that we are linking professional scientists and so many others around the world who really care about what you have dedicated your life to. So are you a scientist who might be interested in joining our team? Let's ask yourselves a couple of questions. Do you have an authentic opportunity to engage our students in contributing to current missions and campaigns? Would you want to become a mentor to a class, a small group, or even an individual student conducting specific research? Maybe are you interested in giving a science talk to our students? Right now we're doing those virtually, and we've had an opportunity to bring hundreds of GAVRT teachers and students around the country and around the world together to hear those talks. And other times we'll do them at a really exciting venue once we're able to do that again. Or do you have a proposal that you're getting ready to submit that maybe needs to have some outreach or citizen science included? If any of these conditions are your situation, we would love to collaborate. We would love to have you join the GAVRT team. One way for you to do that would be to visit our website at www.gavrt.org and look for the Join Us button, or just email us directly at mc@lcer.org. Thank you so much for watching our Hyperwall presentation today.